GeekFam enjoys at 5v5.
Lolita.
Bit too much. Lolita actually goes in the hands of GeekFam. Now that's a good pick too.
Against Natan.
Natan. Oof.
Yeah, great finisher here for GeekFam in the draft.
Back into the land of Dawn for what was a best of three, a lead for GeekFam. But Liquid were able to equalize, bringing us to a full three-game series.
And it's back to this one game that will determine who moves forward up on the standings. GeekFam or Liquid ID?
There was a trap sprung up by GeekFam, but unbeknownst to them, there was actually a response from Team Liquid as well. And look at this Chushin pressure, man. So obnoxious. And there, because of that sequence of events, the trapception, a boy really forced to use that flicker very, very early on.
46 seconds in, it's just really slow in the early game, right? They're really both just playing for the neutral objectives.
Mm-hmm.
The spawn out in the first one, they don't even want to go for like the big fights that we saw. Technically, even with the Kata trying to maneuver forward, both these roamers are more of the passive kind, you know, more of the reactive kind in a lot of ways. So it'll be even more passive in the first two games, at least for the first few minutes up until they get those ultimates.
I'm not sure by IndieHome though, you're seeing that for GeekFam, even Inspire in the hands of Beloisky here, so they're not really concerned about the survivability aspect, even though technically in the early game, there's a lot of damage thrown around, up and about. Beloisky with the Bargain Hunter is trying to go for the... Oh, never mind, Malone Masako! That's a leader.
No flicker earlier, he was baited out, and Favian takes full control. Masako a bit too greedy and will lose out so much gold up top. That is the entire turret shield.
Wait, they can get more than just a turret shield. They're gonna try and go for the whole turret altogether. Beloisky comes through, zoning them away. And now Aran with the 1v2 with the Yeskio.
Law and order committed. Now Valdora will be knocked up. Wow. Like a toy, Valdora popped the Vengeance, but Yeheskio with the two chin will secure that kill. Now Turtle though, Vincent Beloy and a boy is on it. Glory's halfway path, Vincent secures the Turtle, but Beloy knocked up again. On towards that Glory's pathway though. Oh my goodness, man. Yeheskio is playing the members of GeekFam like a toy.
You give him space, this Lantern Girl, and she takes everything. Oh,
whoa, whoa, whoa.
Maybe stuck, stunned up here. We'll use her retribution, though, to find compensation on that neutral objective loss.
Good stuff. No damage just yet for Masako. But as expected, right, GeekFam can't really do it with anything in the early game against Liquid. This is a very high kill pressure game in the early game for Liquid. They have a Carmilla, Chusin, and that Hylos. And on top of it all, they have so much more of the ganking power with the Nolan. This is the weakness of the Fovea too. You're very, very vulnerable to a lot of these ganks, man. You have the Vengeance and your kit is built to all in. If you get shut down from the start of the game, it's gonna get real tough for Valdora.
Quite hairy indeed. For the side of GeekFam too, you can see that because of the Chushin presence, Beloisky has spending a lot of time in the mid lane. So these side lanes that are already on a rather unfavorable matchup, they can't really get assistance from Beloisky the same way they did in the previous games. That means that now Favian, more than Arashiki, has more space to operate. But look at this.
Beloy stunning Favian. No follow-up though, but take a look at the damage already. That was Lokia. Damage test on towards the Roamer.
Half HP in a single combo. You went for the Inspire and no, not tenacity, no firmness. That's what you get. Beloisky is going to be a lot more vulnerable. So we might see the more usual Beloisky, you know, the 0-7 Beloisky power play.
Oh, look at this, man. Aaron Shiki will be able to pick up the first turret of the game. 4 minutes. In 4 minutes. This is an extraordinary lead. 3,000 in 4 minutes. GeekFam needed to stop this early snowball from getting this high, and the fact is, the snowball might be on the worst possible members. Favian has the kill, and Aaron has all of the gold. This is a scary Natan. You can see another neutral objective just taken in the weak side of the map. The Natan should be the weak side. It's now both sides are the strong side. Oh man, what are GeekFam gonna do?
Even in the mid lane here, you can see Yeheskio taking a lot of attention, but GeekFam are the ones playing a lot passive, but Masako.
The 3v1 situation, he will not be able to survive, surely. And that will be Masako taken down.
Arashi, I know it's just the 4th minute of the game, but considering the win cons for both teams, this is literally going a bit too well for TLID.
Even considering the snowballing potential, the Natan in the late game, I know that the Moskov does a lot of damage, but the Natan even more so. And if you look at the battle spells for the side of Geek Fam, no purifies, by the way. So Team Liquid with the more dynamic, aggressive ways to start the fight, they don't have any ways. Geek Fam have no ways to really get away from those plays.
Is this a Natan or a Brody, folks? That's what you see from Brody's, you know, taking turrets, rotating and taking another turret. Geek Fam have no answers for this. It's a 4,000 gold lead already, and now they can honestly just look for a fight. They are so far ahead. Gaheskill can do whatever he wants. It's just reactive for Geek Fam at this point. They all have to farm. They all have to wait for the mid-game power spike for some of these members. But even then, when they get to that point, TLID will be so far ahead.
It's almost like the worst scenario to be playing, to be forced to play reactive against a team like Team Liquid. This is like one of the teams that are very dynamic, very unpredictable, so being reactive against this team, it's a bit too dangerous, but Masako? Hang on a second.
No, don't show up, Masako.
Yeah. Do it!
Cure of Misery is there. The damage though, my goodness. The kills is still 4 love. 4,000 gold lead, almost 5 here. Oh, Malefic Roar already, Zal. I think he will test his damage again to Woloisky after this Malefic Roar, man.
Oh, man. Free. Everything. The flicker was free, Arashi.
Wasn't really required either. Masako did not have to show himself. He saw that Weedy was already there. Still went for it to try and do something. But now, look at that. Ihescu already low, but the purple buff is taken by Fabian. It's gonna get worse and worse. If Geekfan can hang on to this mid turret, maybe. But look at this. Vincent actually finding a turret on the top side, but at what cost? The turret in the bottom side might be taken in exchange.
Just by the minions alone, it's slowly but surely getting taken away. No one's dealing with it just yet. It actually might fall, or at least it'll be so low to a point where TLID can just force a siege down below.
Oh no, it's taken down by the minions!
Yeah. Last minute too. Wow, Geek Fam. Losing so many turrets already, they're still focused so much on the mid one here just to get the safety from the damages. But look at Witty behind enemy lines.
Not a R7 though, who is restreaming now. Ihescuel with the Land of Prayer. He's like a puppeteer, man. Just controlling the puppets.
Yeah, shout out to Mr. Chip here, restreaming R7. That's his nickname now. Unfortunately, we don't get to see a lot of Mr. Chip in the game, so I'm glad we get to see Mr. Chip on the screen here. Oh, he's shocked, he's surprised.
That's
a great look. Featured me. Starts laughing now. R7, man, always a joy to see him, a legend of Ara Kihoshi. But back to the game here. Man, we were talking already about this, right? The fact that, yes, they have ways to deal with the Hylos, but they're gonna have to wait. It's still conditional. Masako needs to wait for the three items. It isn't the normal way we see an answer towards the Hylos. And the fact that he's so far behind, will even get to a point where he can deal with the Hylos.
And to top it off, Vincent as well, one of the key factors to victory in game number 1 and 2 for Geek Fam. What is he able to do right here, right? He's actually shut down, he's getting his camps taken away. So even the early to mid pressure that this Julian should have really isn't allowed by Team Liquid at all. Now with the Lord coming up, this is one of these objectives that can't really be ignored. If Geek Fam want to let it go, they have to try and get something for it because they know that most of the turrets outside the base most likely will fall from this Lord.
Man, you can even see it earlier. Well, this is the free Lord, ladies and gentlemen, in the 8th minute of the game. The purple buff, they actually need to give Masako the purple buff just to give him farm. Aran might be flanking. Oh, Glorious Pathway.
They try to cut him off.
They're trying to find Vincent to isolate him, but Woloisky.
The Lantern.
Woloisky's gonna recall here, trying. He's sacrificing Vincent, technically 2v1, with the Puppeteer. Fabian, though, secures it. Wow. He secures the BOD as well. More physical damage.
The Usurper always has to take those kills, man. That could have been Jusen's.
Nah, Jusen doesn't need the kills. He doesn't need to snowball. Ihescu already has 2 anyways. Fabian wants to get more, but look at that. A boy already very, very low. Now with the Glorious Pathway, can he get something more?
Perfect Glorious Pathway. A boy forced to use that IMU. The Lord trying to tank that mid, trying to distract the waves as well. Aran, though, from the flanks. Opening vision, the turret mid defaults. Geek Fam, though, will defend their inner mid turret.
7,000 gold lead, still with the Lord alive. There's going to be another wave of enhanced minions that they can utilize to go in for another push. That is a slow push in the bottom lane. And there should be another tier 2 for TLID. Heck, they might not even crack open one of these turrets. You know, GeekFam don't really have the best of clears, especially with Masako being so far behind.
Ooh, stun with the Law and Order. Glory's pathway popped as well. Fabian jumps in. Fedora now knocked back up. Lord still up here, will be taken care of though. Maloyski now is going to be soaking a lot of damage. Still able to survive the damage though. It's 5 and love still. Kill-wise, no kill whatsoever for side of GeekFam.
Good revitalized earlier by Baloyski on this Lolita. But again, they can't really do anything. They cannot walk up even, Arashi.
It's just a Tsushin with the Lantern. Now Baloyski out of the base!
Oh, that's
a good kill! Another kill on towards a boy. Two members down here, 5v3. The base turret will be the main target, will be taken down. Surely, Fedora finds the first kill on the board for GeekFam, and it's towards a very important player. Aaron Cheeky goes down.
It's important, but it's not a shutdown, unfortunately, right? So the base turret pick there was still worth it. I mean, even if they traded for Aaron plus Witty or Aran, it would have been worth it. Aaron already has a Holy Crystal, so he's not in any rush to get the Divine Glaive. You know, it's just another bonus at this point. 11 minutes, Holy Crystal already on the way to Divine Glaive. That is more than enough for the Natan.
Teemo could have gotten more value from the other waves in the mid and top side, but they'll take that, man. They're still having GeekFam locked into their own base, and looking at the items, yes, you'll understand that there's no real danger to this Tsushin at this point. No one can just dive in and be a real threat because of the safety, right? You have a built-in flicker, technically, in your kit that gives you a shield as well. So you can afford to build aggressively, and with the Glowing Wand, with the Ice Queen's Wand, this is a massive power spike. Whoever gets tagged even a little bit by the Lantern will most likely get caught. And with the Glowing Wand applying that passive, the Life Bane, to everyone at the same time in the middle of a big fight, gonna be so difficult as Team Liquid ID free Lord once again. GeekFam, they've done the impossible before, but what can they do now? It's looking more and more desperate as time goes on.
Good move by Liquid there, by the way. You know, just seeing the Lord spawning at 1140, waits for 12 minutes to get that enhanced version of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
But also, Masako has yet to complete the DHS. The 3-item power spike isn't even there in the 12th minute of the game. This is gonna be tough. It's another siege by the cavalry.
Look at how Yesuka is positioning. She knows there's not gonna be any kind of engage. Arando cuts everyone off with a glitch pathway.
Oh, that's a hit and run by Fabian. 5v4 now. This might be the final push. Now the Neuron Blast pops. Witty though jumps in. Oh, Fabian finds a double. Baloy goes down one by one. It's a maniac for maniac as Flave finds the base as well. 2-1. It's a reverse sweep.
The horse stops and the horse charged. The cavalry returning the favor, reverse sweeping GeekFam. What an absolutely phenomenal performance from Liquid in game 3 to close it out. We got